And the shining Rocky Mountains looked down on the people coming. Strong and sturdy freedom-loving settlers, cowboy, pioneers. Now no foreign crown would rule them. Now a nation strong was standing. Even bigger was it growing, added Iowa, Wisconsin. Then broke through the shining mountains, staked a claim on California. Panned the gold out of its rivers, irrigated desert valleys. Oregon, Minnesota, Kansas, now were added to the total, making 34 the number of the states now in the Union. And the years 1860 to 65, the history books are full of it. The sadness, the heartbreak, and the songs from that
everybody.
Period.
Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to the page, wherever you're finding me,
tell
Facebook, YouTube, I'm around. Today is November 5th, and it
when
is
the nation was torn
election
asunder.
Day, and I would advise you to probably get out and do your civil duty and vote. Get out and be responsible and do that just because it matters today, I think. And, you know, a lot of people say, this is the election that matters. This is the most important election of your life. And I'm not really a political person. I'm kind of politically homeless at the moment. But I do agree. This probably is the most important election of our lives. So whether you see it one way or the other, it doesn't really matter to me. All I want you guys to know is that we should stand up for integrity, justice, and things like that. And our country's falling apart, literally, at the moment. So maybe we should vote one way or the other as we see it, would help. So, hey, I love you guys. I want you guys to pray for somebody specific. My sister-in-law, she lost her horse this last week due to an injury, a fluke injury, and she lost her horse, and it's just been on my mind constantly, you guys. And I don't really want to give out her name because I don't know if she's comfortable with that, but let's just say A. We'll call her A. She needs a lot of prayers because she lost her horse. So hey, here's our thought for today. During our thoughts about the rewards that have come to us as a result of our new way of living, we find that we have new kinds of homes, new relationships with our spouses and children. Also peace, contentment, hope, faith, charity, and a new ambition. So what are some of the things we have lost? Each one of us can answer this question in many ways. I have lost much of my fear. It used to control me. It paralyzed my efforts. Fear always got me down. It made me an introvert, an ingrown person. So when fear was replaced by faith, I got well. Have I lost some of my fears? I know I have. So here's our meditation for today, this election day, November 5th. The world would sooner be brought close to God. His will would sooner be done on earth. If all who acknowledge him gave themselves unreservedly to being used by him. God can use every human being as a channel for divine love and power. What delays the bringing of the world closer to God is the backwardness of his followers. If each one lived each day for God and allowed God to work through them, then the world would soon be drawn much closer to God, to him, right? Its founder and the preserver. So today we pray that we may be used as a channel to express divine love. Amen. Oh, yeah. And I pray that I may also live as to bring God's Spirit closer to the world. Hey, we're going to get into our daily reflections reading today just because I think we could definitely use it. We need it. Today is going to be a big day. And here is November 5th's daily reflection reading. The quality of faith. This has to do with the quality of faith. In no deeper meaningful sense had we ever taken stock of ourselves. We had not even prayed rightly. We had always said, grant me my wishes instead of thy will be done. And that's in the big book. Oh, that's in the 12 and 12, page 32. My mistake. God does not grant me material possessions, take away my suffering, or spare me from disasters, but he does give me a good life, the ability to cope, and the peace of mind. My prayers are simple. First, they express my gratitude for the good things in my life, regardless of how hard I have to search for them. And second, I ask only for the strength and the wisdom to do his will, to carry those out. He answers with solutions to my problems, sustaining my ability to live through daily frustrations with a serenity I did not believe existed, and with the strength to practice the principles of this program in all my everyday affairs. Ooh, sounds like a lot, like step 12. I love it. Get out there, be safe and sober today. If you need anything, please reach out. I love each and every one of you. Continue prayers for my family. We're still going through some stuff, but hey, we're going to get through onward and upward. Love you.